So I've shared something on my channel the last week or so that I truly believe, but I'm doing my best to check with my experts, my millionaires, to really see if I'm just crazy and all wet. Casey, you ready?
Yes, bring it on.
So something I'm starting to tell my audience is, and I believe this, it's just not a saying, that 8% mortgage rates are a good thing for the housing market today. So if I were to tell you, Casey, that I believe 8% mortgage rates are a good thing for the housing market and 5% mortgage rates are a bad thing for the housing market, how would that feel?
It sounds bad. Like if you were to say 8% is great, that sounds really bad. But as an investor, knowing all the strategies and the plays you can make as a buyer, 8% sounds really appealing. There's a lot of things you can do with an 8% interest rate and all that surround that. For example, as soon as people see 8%, well, it used to be 6%, then 7%, right? Then 8%, people will be afraid at 7%. Now what are we, we're seeing people are cool with 7%, right? Buyers are coming back. It's much more competition than a month and a half ago when it was just become 10 of 7. Now everyone's cool with 7. So when it hits 8, what's going to happen? It's like, it's kind of like that new Threads thing on Instagram. Get in right now while it's hot before it's old. That's it with 8% interest rates. Get in now while everyone's scared before they're used to it. And then the 9% is the new thing, right? So when we see 8% interest rates and people are scared, just like 7%, we're going to see buyers back out. I already have some people saying, oh, I'm too scared, too, interest rates too high. How do you cash flow? It's like that. How do cash flow is not the question we should be asking.
Yeah, wrong question. Yeah,
exactly. Wrong question. So when you see 8% interest rates hit the market, we're going to see buyers back off, especially owner-occupied buyers are going to be like, hell no. So now we're going to have investors scared. Oh my God, no. How do I cash flow? Blah, blah. So what is that going to mean? That means we're going to see properties sit on the market longer until sellers go, I got to lower the price. No one's offering me what I thought. So we're going to see long days on the market. Sellers are going to start getting crazy. Now it's going to be towards the end of the year, right? Christmas time, Thanksgiving, winter, especially where it snows. It's going to start really slowing down. It even was slowing down last year and it was supposed to be crazy. And it was, but not as crazy as it could have been if it wasn't winter. So we're seeing long days on the market. Interest rates are high. Sellers are still not yet lowering their prices because 8% is too new. So what can we do since we're not scared? We're going to go in with lowball, it's on what it makes sense to us, right? I don't really care what the seller is asking because who sets the price? The buyer sets the price. Now, if there's another buyer that wants to pay more than me, I guess they win. Otherwise, I'm setting the price for me and the seller can take it or not. So I'm going to still run my numbers with the interest rate that I'm going to get. Now, I may try and get a 2% seller credit so I can buy my rate down. They don't really need to know that. You just say, you know what? Rates are really high right now, seller. And, you know, your house has been sitting on the market 45 days. This is what it's worth to me. Is it $40,000 below asking? Yeah. Take it or don't take it. Enough of those offers. Someone's going to say yes.
Yeah, I think this is really going to, this is going to benefit really one rental at a time students. Because again, what I teach and talk about is focus and daily discipline. In a market of 8% mortgage rates, my students should understand what a great deal is. And that's probably below list price. That's okay. In a market that is slowing down and days on market getting older, that's a good thing. And then you add in, you know, mortgage rate buy downs or whatever you want to, you know, seller credits. What we are going to find, and this will take time and follow-up, is who needs to sell versus who wants to sell. I've been doing this 20-some-odd years. I've only interacted with motivated sellers a few times. If we can keep rates over 7 or 8% through the winter, it is going to be very easy to find a motivated seller, and I'm super excited for it.
I'm really excited. I mean, it does suck. Don't get me wrong. Nobody wants 8% rate. But if you can get the property to cash flow now at your 8% or a buy down to 7%, one day you can refinance. And I'm telling you, these properties that do cash flow, at least single family, I will tell you from my limited experience, it will still be a cheap property. It'll be something under $200,000 in most areas across the country. Anything above 200 or 250, there's not a snowball's chance in hell it's going to cash flow. Right? A single family, multi, different story. So we're talking about a refinance on a $100,000 to $200,000 property. I mean, it's going to be pretty cheap. You know what I mean? I'm not super worried, and I'm going to be planning on holding the property for a long time. But what's also happening? We got interest rates, we've got inflation. Inflation is still high. And what else does inflation do to real estate? It raises the prices. So great. My equity is going to go up. I am not crying about it at all.
Yeah. There's a shirt that somebody made that says, I use inflation to get rich. Ask me how. It's,
you I know, like this, that.
Yeah. Again, it's just so powerful. In a market that's slowing down, days on market, everybody pays 8% cost to capital. Write great offers. You're going to get told no a lot. Follow up, because a no today could be a yes tomorrow. Most of my deals during 2010, 11, and 12 were done through follow-up. So folks, just do the work. Be excited. Get rid of that mindset of nothing cash flows, I give up. Let all the idiots do that. You just, you know, redouble down. You focus daily discipline, 20 minutes a day. Write great offers, follow up, and you can get yours. Casey, how can people follow you?
People can follow me on Instagram, Brick by Brick Wealth, as long as YouTube, Twitter, TikTok, Threads, all the places.
There you go. Thank you so much, Casey.